Good evening, everyone. My name is John Balsba. I'm the headmaster here at Trinity School at River Ridge. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our spring concert, which is the culmination of our annual Fine Arts Festival. I want to extend a special welcome to any guests we have with us, as well as the new families who will be joining Trinity next year and who came this evening to our new family introduction. Thank you all for coming. Tonight, we're going to celebrate the work of the 9th and 10th graders in choir and the work of the 7th, 8th, 11th, and 12th graders in studio art, as well as the work of our extracurricular vocal and instrumental groups. One of our juniors approached me this week when the art first went up on the walls, and she was just beaming and said, "This is my favorite time of year." And I really do have to agree, it is mine too. Because this is the time of year that we get to celebrate the fruit of the work that the students have done all year. Not only in the arts, but also in mathematics, sciences, and humanities as well. Because in all of those educational endeavors, learning genuinely involves a creative effort that produces something not only hard-earned, but also beautiful. If you're less familiar with the school and our approach, I want to point out to you that we have a common curriculum here that includes all of these arts, in addition to drama and instrumental music. So the 9th and 10th grade choirs that you will hear tonight are not elective or select groups. This is all of our 9th and 10th grade students singing together. And the art you see on the walls this evening is the work of all of our students. Before we start, I'd like to ask you to silence any cell phones you might have brought with you. I hope you enjoy the evening, and without further ado, I would like to welcome the 9th and 10th grade girls' choirs to perform our first number. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, first of all, before I announce outer words, I really want to thank parents for sending their kids here. This is really awesome. So we get to enjoy beautiful music, but I'm always impressed with the artwork because we struggle and you go through this and not everybody wants to necessarily be in art. I'm sure there's a few who'd rather be kicking around a ball instead. And yet they put so much effort into it and it turns out just fabulous. So every year I'm pretty stunned, right? Our judge this year actually is a first for us. Her name is Stephanie Hunder, and she's on the faculty, the art faculty for Concordia University. But what's unique about her is she is our first prize winner for the first Christian Arts Festival that Trinity's had. She couldn't make it here tonight, but she was very also stunned by what we could do at a high school. So really, really impressive. Nick Fox could not be here this evening, I don't think, but he also teaches the 11th and 12th grade boys, so just a tremendous job there as well. Alrighty, let me get down to what we want to hear. For Best Illuminated Word, Aiden Willard, and if you guys are here when I call your name, certainly you can stand up. If not, congratulate them when you see them next time. So Best Illuminated Word is Aiden Willard. I'm going to save the portrait one for just a second here. Best Colored Pencils, Elizabeth Neal. The Best Pastel is Madeline Brilski. The Best Watercolor is Jane Hulse. Best acrylic painting this year is Anna Payne. And the best figure drawing is Mary Rahway. Now here's why I wanted to save best portrait drawing for last, because the best portrait drawing also happens to be the Best of Show Award. He was pretty stunning with this really impressive graphite pencil portrait. And I think he's standing somewhere in the vicinity over here, and that would be Eddie Hoy. Enjoy the art show and on with the music.
Can't get away that easily. So I just want to thank, before we have our final number here, which I think Mr. Roland was putting the thing down for, right, Mr. Roland? You're putting this down for the final number, right? Okay, so before we get to the final number, I want to thank all of our conductors and the people who helped us with tonight. Mary Beth Amundsen, thank you very much. Thank you to Karen Edge. And thank you to Gene Rylander. And finally, I have a very special announcement. After 19 years at Trinity School, this will be Mr. Jim Rowland's last year at the school, and therefore his last year conducting. Mr. Rowland is a great musician. He's a great lover of music. And I think he thrives when he is passing that joy on to others, as you saw tonight. He is also a steady, even-keeled person to work with and has always been a rock, even in the stormiest artistic seas, and he will be greatly missed by all. So we want to take a minute to honor Mr. Lowe.
right, could all the teachers Mr. Balsbo named please come up here to accept your gifts, along with Mrs. Soriano and Mr. Fox?
We'd like to thank Mrs. Amundsen and Mrs. Edge for their hard work in the instruments department, Mr. Rowland and Mrs. Rylander for their work in the choral department, and Mr. Fox and Mrs. Soriano in the art department. I don't public speak.
Fitzgerald. There's a tad bit of Irish in me.